وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا.
Right? We'll talk about today as well. I really want to get down to this.
Well, issue.
Yeah. I can conduct the debate as I like in my time, right? As long as we stick to the topic, right? Which is Halala. And you can use rhetoric. I can use rhetoric. Rhetoric is a tool of debating. If you don't know what it is, then you need to go and find out what it is. Once we use it skillfully, it will clarify our positions. So this is what I want to do. Can we?
When you ready?
I'm ready right now.
We need the mic.
So can we have the mic?
No, you're gonna bring the voice.
Sorry, no. I don't accept that.
No.
Otherwise, it's not. There's no point of having a debate.
Why not?
Because even with Paul, when she had a debate, Paul's voice is less than her.
We gave him a choice to stand on the ladder. He didn't decide to, so he was down there. We couldn't pick him up.
No. Why can we not share the mic? It's only fair to do that. So when it's my turn, I take the mic. Because when the video comes out online, it doesn't look right. Go and watch all your debate. Not one, all of your debate. So I think it's only fair to share the mic. It's justice, which is very difficult in this case for some reason.
I mean, what do I do? Like, pass it over?
Doesn't matter how big my voice is.
It does.
But in the mic, both voices will come out.
Just pass the mic.
Both voices will come out.
It will come out equally.
You know what? For politeness, I'm very happy to pass it.
No, but for the sake of justice. For the sake of justice, yeah. That's justice. Because it's going on your channel. Can I hold it in my hand?
Because
the problem is then she's gonna be. So we're gonna have to take her off. Take them off for her as well.
If I pick up her voice.
Listen, this will definitely. Here, and he's standing in the middle. There.
Right.
So you are there in the middle. You could pass the mic here. That's it.
First time, man. First time he's balanced.
With him. Keep the mic with him. That everyone will be.
So,
happy.
Can we begin? You want to start? Go ahead. Two minutes. Who's keeping time?
I can keep time.
Yeah, no problem.
Mic and time.
Yeah.
Yes, go ahead.
Hey, should I do the time?
You want to do the time?
I'm too sure.
You do the time.
I'll do the time.
Oh, the sun is going to blind. Okay, yeah. That's a good idea.
We thought about that. Amateurs.
Who's
that,
by the way?
That's Lizzie's, I think. Lizzie's.
I know.
Lizzie's, yeah.
Patrick, get
in the middle. Patrick, I don't have an app for...
Fix your hair, Patrick.
I don't have the app.
Alright. Okay, tell me when we're ready to go.
Okay.
I have to check. Double check if she doesn't bring it there again.
I pray you come to know Jesus.
You love Jesus.
You know, for
Jesus.
Jesus was not a liar. He was not a hate preacher. On the day of judgment, he will tell the liars to get away from him. He will tell the liars to get away from him.
I have a question.
Wait. I have a question for people like
Patrick,
a very reasonable man as I know him. Lizzie, I'm willing to accept that she's reasonable as well. Okay, and because I know these people have human instincts, I'm asking you a question.
Simple question.
Do you not see
how you are misrepresenting Islam or faith. Deliberately. Yeah. You have been told that it is haram in Islam. The Prophet said it's haram. It is cursed.
Scholars
are saying it is haram. You will go in the house of Islam. You will pick some example, extremists, some lost cases, some misguided people. You will say, this is Islam. Ignore the 99%. You know what the sunnah is?
It's a whole
sunnah is what the Prophet said. So when the Prophet said, it is cursed, why do you still insist? It is Islam.
Okay, can I answer? Do you mind if I answer?
The debate is over, but you can answer.
Yeah. You did ask a question.
Yes, okay. Go ahead.
You made it. Why are you misrepresenting Islam? That's the question.
Well, this is my question to you.
Yeah. No, he asked the question.
I am not misrepresenting Islam. I'm going straight back to your holy books, to the Quran. I'm reading out the Hadith. Okay, I'm reading them as they are. I'm reading them
so
as they are.
When the Prophet curses,
I read the Hadith, I read the Quran, and I'm asking a question.
No, you're not asking a question. What you have made statements on your Facebook page. You have made statements on your YouTube account. You're making videos and you're telling people this is Islam. But it's not Islam.
Adnan,
let us finish.
If I am
misrepresenting
Islam, okay, if there's a way that
Islam disappears. Yeah, destroy it.
Guys,
let her finish. You won't civilize.
Yes. All Muslims come to Christ.
Get this on video, yeah? Even if you want this sent to bed.
Lizzie, finish.
You got this on camera, yeah?
This is the love of the gospel. He wants Islam destroyed.
Chase me.
The loving gospel of Jesus Christ.
Same.
You see, I want Islam destroyed.
Lizzie, finish.
No, wait. I will let him finish.
No, imagine.
I said that. Imagine I said that. I would be on news.
Patrick.
I would be on the news.
And tomorrow, Guantanamo.
Very honest.
Is it the media?
So you recuse me.
Yes.
I'm just saying.
Yes, you are,
okay,
Mr.
That I go to the Quran, I go to the Hadith, I read it as it is, and I ask my Muslim friends, please, can they explain it to me? Okay? This is what the verse seems to say. The average person reading it, and it seems sometimes I bring up the verses that are very difficult, and I ask my Muslim friends, how would you exegete these verses, okay? And if there is a peaceful version, if there is a reasonable way of explaining, then I would, I would
today,
like to
today, what
hear
did
it.
You learn today?
I would like to hear it.
Okay,
and
did
I would
you
like
learn
to know if it's convincing or not, okay?
Did you
that
learn
not
today?
Not misrepresenting Islam. Okay. This is just being truthful about Islam.
Okay.
Can I say something?
What did you learn today? What did you learn after this discussion today? What did you learn?
I will tell you that I am not convinced by your argument.
Even though that prophet, even though, even
I'm
though,
not convinced. No, you've had the last say, so it's my turn to talk.
I'm asking questions. So,
argument,
specific. So we are hitting the nail on the head. Even though there is no evidence whatsoever for halala marriage in Islam, number one, no evidence. No evidence.
I've shown you the evidence, sir. I've shown you
show me, show me halala marriage anywhere in Islam.
I've shown you the Quran. I've given you three hadith. I've given you two.
It is not halal. It's normal.
Okay,
it is normal marriage. Do you know what that means?
Can I just say, it's your turn now to show me your evidence. If I've got this
my evidence is, what you're calling halala was categorically in words. The Prophet used the same word. Muhallil. Muhallil. La'an Allah. Prophet said, it is the curse of God be upon the one who does this. Halala. Halala. Come on. Come on. Come on, Christians. Come on.
Let's do it from a numbers game, okay? I gave you three hadith, one Quranic verse, two schools of
it doesn't mean that. The word halala is not there.
And let us finish.
One hadith versus six pieces of
evidence.
Maybe you can bring me something else. Something from the Maliki, something from the Hanbali, another hadith, something else that means that I've got it completely wrong. But you've actually not provided your evidence.
Lizzie, wait.
You need to provide your evidence.
Are you deliberately ignoring what I'm saying?
That halala marriage is not Islamic, and you have not done that. All you've done is come back to this program and said it over.
Lizzie, are you truthful? You wanted to find the truth. Are you truthful in that?
Sincere.
I'm very
sincere.
You tell me something I've said.
Listen. Do you know what are the conditions of marriage in Islam?
The conditions of marriage.
Suppose a woman divorced three times and she wanted to marry again. What is the condition of marrying again? Do you know what is it?
Well, according to Surah 2, Ayah 230, okay, if she's been divorced and she wants to be reconciled,
no, the condition is asking of the marriage.
She needs to consummate that marriage.
That's not the answer to this question.
This is not answer. I'm asking you, do you know what are the conditions? If a woman wanted to divorce another man, what is the condition there?
No, maybe you can explain to me.
Okay. One of the main conditions, it shouldn't be temporary, first of all. They shouldn't intend to divorce. They should intend to establish another family. Yeah. That's what they have. Now, if it didn't work out, their life, and she found that this man, the other man, is bad, is worse than the first one, then after she's divorced from the new one, she's entitled to go back to the first, if she doesn't wish, she's entitled to marry any other man, yeah. Which means the condition of marriage applies everywhere. Doesn't mean she's entitled to go to marry someone temporarily, and he is thinking, I'm going to divorce her the next day. Is he not allowed to do that in Islam? Called mut'a in Islam, in Sunnah. Okay,
wait, halala is when there's an intention.
Listen, do you mean
to divorce a woman, wait. When there's an intention to divorce a woman, before you get married to her, there's an intention that this woman will be divorced so that she can go back to her first husband. This is what halala is. Yeah. Okay, wait. Right, now, in Islam,
marry another man, yeah?
Right, sir, can I just give you my...
The meaning marry another man, the condition of marriage, it shouldn't be temporary, do you understand?
So did you learn
that? Did you learn this?
Right, so I
understand. Are you open to that truth?
Are you
open to that
propaganda already?
Yes. I just want to know if you're open to that truth.
Adnan, give us some breath.
Okay, this is a debate, okay? Of course, I will listen, but I need to be allowed to...
Go ahead, please.
So I appreciate that what you're saying is that temporary marriage is not allowed. However, can you show me from your sources, can you show me from the Hadith or the Tafsir or the Quran, okay, where this temporary aspect is prohibited? It's absolutely banned.
The very Hadith.
Okay? I'm talking to you, you can show that to me.
Okay.
Right? Because also, I mean, a lot of the debate about this, I've been reading up about the debate about is about intentionality. The idea that, you know, it's what your haram if you somehow go into the marriage with the intention of getting divorced again.
What I'm not seeing
in the Hadith or the Quran or the Tafsirs is really any unpacking of this intentionality. It seems like what the Quran is saying, what the Hadith is saying, is it's a question that really is the heart is lawfulness, not intentionality. Do you see what I mean? And either way, the issue is more the issue of lawfulness, because that's what the Quran says.
He will give you the report.
And the intentionality is a secondary
issue. Just a minute. Now here. No, the secondary is the main issue, because in Islam, there is two conditions for any act of worship in Islam. First of all, it has to be the intention, and as well it has
to be out of marriage.
And anything in Islam, it has to be under two main conditions. Anything in Islam.
Intention.
The intention is the first one. That's the first thing.
Where are your sources? So when you say
the first Hadith of Bukhari.
The first Hadith of Bukhari, if you read it. Yeah.
All actions are due to the intention.
All actions
are based upon intention. That's number one Hadith.
The second Hadith. Whatever who brings something which is our way, our methodology is not from us, then it is rejected. Yeah? Which means this is the second condition. So it has to be, first of all, the intention. The second thing has to be following the guidance of our Prophet. So those are the two main conditions. Marriage, divorce, and all these things.
Everything.
Now, when I intend to marry someone, if I have intention to divorce, this marriage already... Yeah. It's already negated. It's already not valid. Why? Because it's not allowed to do that. Interesting. So that's the first thing. The second point, when we say, where is the temporary marriage? There are many hadith that the Prophet, peace be upon him, he condemned the temporary marriage. Not only that. For example, we have the narration of Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said that the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited that.
Bukhari,
you can find it.
Mut'a marriage.
The Mut'a marriage condemned by the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam.
So he said it's haram. So it's clear cut, it's haram.
Okay, can you give me the number?
I'll show it to you right now.
Get it there. So anyway, we have many hadith that says that the temporary marriage is not allowed.
That was taboo.
Now, when Allah says in the Quran, "Hatta tanki hazul
jalil," okay, if we show it to you,
that temporary marriage is haram in Islam, will that change your mind? Will that change your mind? We're going to get to some conclusion.
One second.
You've
got two against one at the moment.
Okay.
You should be one against one,
ready?
Right?
You are on one.
Yeah, you can come in as well if you want.
So, I think, are we not confusing two different things? One is temporary marriage, and one is halala marriage, okay? Where a woman wants to be reconciled with...
Can you define
I'll define the difference. Okay, so halala marriage... according to Quran, it's Surah 2, Ayah 230, where a woman who wants to be reconciled to her first husband has to marry another man, consummate it, and go back. And technically, wait a minute,
okay. There's love and marriage or not love and marriage?
And mutter marriage, yeah, is this right? Temporary marriage is really all that it is. You get married just for a period of time, and then you get divorced. And actually, it's nothing, that the reconciliation element is not, it's not, so, nothing so to question, do with that.
So the question is,
are we talking about two different things?
No, we're talking about one thing.
The halal marriage.
What's the halal marriage? What is it? Is it for a period of time or is it for
marriage? No.
When I say halal, someone wants to marry halal. Does he need to marry for a temporary time?
No, because the intention is halal. Wait. The intention is halal, right? Lizzie, are you listening? Wait, let her come back up. When you call it halala marriage, it is very obvious you're referring to something that is already known as halala marriage before it is conducted. Agreed?
Yes? Whatever you want to call it.
No, you're calling it halala marriage. You started it. There's no such thing as halala marriage.
I'm referring to the practice
that
you're
granting
to Surah 2, Ayah 230.
And what is that practice?
Explain. Read it again.
It's just his filming as well.
It's not lawful.
Is it lawful marriage?
Do you know what marriage is?
Another man.
What's the definition of marriage?
The definition of marriage. First of all, the two sides have to agree. There should be as well two witnesses. There should be people that have to be announced.
And no intention of
So there is no any intention that they're gonna marry for a temple.
Let's say.
Did you get this?
Okay, let me say.
Did you get this?
Okay,
did you get it? Yes or no? Because
I'm gonna ask you a question. Yeah. Right?
Okay.
So I appreciate what you're saying is that what is haram is that it cannot be like a thing of convenience. It cannot be done temporarily simply in order to get to be reconciled.
No.
Okay, that's what you're saying. Is that right?
No. If that element is there, that what we're saying is if there is an element,
it's haram.
No.
That's not what you're saying.
Wait. Let me. If there is an element of abnormality, because a marriage contract is well known in Islam, it is a marriage contract. That's what it's called, and it has conditions. Okay. Any abnormality involved will null. Will render the contract
nullify.
Null and void. Do you understand that?
Right. So let's say I accept your argument for the sake of argument, okay, that any kind of temporary convenience element is wrong and haram and forbidden. Okay? Anyway, isn't it just plain wrong to put on a woman the condition that she has to go and remarry somebody else in order to be... Why does the Quran add this for the reconciliation to be valid? Why does it put... I mean, why doesn't the Quran... Can I finish? Why doesn't the Quran say, if you get a divorce, you can go and marry again, full stop? Why doesn't it say that? Why does it say that in order for your first marriage to be reconciled, you have to do this thing? Why doesn't Allah simply say...
Now, let me respond. Listen, I understand your question.
And be reconciled.
You're repeating the sanctity of marriage.
Okay.
Why does Allah do that? Why does he not let him simply be reconciled?
You want to say more?
Okay. All right. Listen to this. Carry on. Listen. Lisa, I'm talking to you. Listen. There is a whole chapter in Quran about divorce. And God said in the Quran, the divorce, first of all, before the people get to the divorce, there are things that should be done. Yeah?
Procedures.
Not something which is like, someone who is divorced. Yep. First of all, that the people, before it happens, they have to try
arbitration.
To arbitration. First of all, they have to discuss between themselves. Then after that, if they didn't work,
3 months.
Then they bring someone from her relative, someone who is from somebody, her father, or someone who is... Yeah, someone whose wife from his family, and as well, he will bring someone who those are not biased. Then they are gonna come and discuss to keep the marriage together. Yeah, if it didn't work, to negotiate those ones, you said seeking advice. This is what you said in the beginning. Seek advice.
That's good. In Islam,
listen to this.
Why does it have to be to say this too.
Listen, I didn't interrupt you. Listen, the other thing. What happened now? If these two people, they will discuss and they will see there is no way to go on, and the problems happen, then they are entitled to divorce, first of all. First divorce. Then they will stay for 3 months. Up to the 3 months, the divorce is there. Yeah? Now, if the divorce that happened, they are entitled. Then if you turn her back, for example, both of them, they agreed to get together. Yeah? So the divorce is not something that's a game. You divorce and then the next day, the next day she comes back. And then until infinity times of divorce, you have to be limited. So the people, they don't play games with the divorce because it breaks the heart of the people. If a woman is divorced, for example, you know what happens to the woman when she's divorced. You know what happens to the man when he's divorced. So it's not something small. So they have a chance, another chance. Let me finish. They have another chance.
Be patient because
then the next chance, then they have another chance. They get together. The problems happen. Listen.
Try and listen.
The problem happens. Then they have to bring back again two people again. Okay. Then the same problem. Divorce and every time. The third time, there is no way, which means they have enough opportunity of divorces.
Yes.
That's how
the procedure.
No,
you understand? No, wait, 1 second. I want to make a point.
You said,
no.
No,
I am.
No, you're coming in every time.
Wait, his point.
Lizzie,
I am answering your question right now. I'm answering your question.
Why doesn't Allah simply let them be reconciled?
Very good. Very good question.
Why not?
Can I respond to it?
Can I respond to it? Can I respond to it? Why cannot God just simply let you go? Why does he have to kill someone on the cross? Why does he simply not let you go? Why cannot God just simply let you go? Why does he have to kill someone on the cross? Why does he simply not let you go? Why can he not simply let you go? Why is God so cruel that he has to kill his own son on the cross? Can you answer that question? Once you answer that question, then I will answer your question. Why God has to do things like that? Okay, answer my question. So this is why the debate is over. You know, in the 19th century, similarly, a Christian scholar was having a debate with a Muslim scholar. He said, why couldn't God? Why couldn't God? Why couldn't God save the Prophet's grandson? The scholar, the Muslim scholar, rhetorically responded, God was crying. So the Christian scholar asked, why was God crying? God was crying, he responded, because I couldn't save my own son. How could I save your grandson? Right? So same answer. Same answer comes back to you. So why can God not simply forgive your sin?
Because you said you have to ask a question. What? And after that, you said you have to know
the debate is over.
You said God didn't have a and you said there is two people.
You worship Allah.
The Arab Christian. You worship Allah.